Let us analyze the IV characteristic graphs of the NTC thermistor or semiconductors in general. Now, what we want to look at over here, of course, is the IV graph. You will notice that, again, these substances tend to be a little good at first. They obey Ohm's law, but then after that, they start to deviate from Ohm's law when the voltage is high. But what you will notice, however, is that if you look at this red line from the origin to the curve, right, the gradient of this line gets steeper and steeper after a while. And since the resistance of this component is the inverse gradient of the red line, then we can say that as the potential difference across it increases, then the resistance must decrease. Now, let us understand why this happens. Now, of course, we know that when the potential difference goes up, more energy is dissipated per unit charge, and so there'll be more heat dissipated, which causes the temperature to go up. This creates two effects, as we have seen before. One is an increase in your thermal lattice vibrations, okay, and the other one is an increase in your charge carrier concentration. So, of course, when your thermal lattice vibrations increase, remember your thermal lattice vibrations are typically huge ions in the system, okay? And so when your electrons start to go through, they collide a little bit more with these things, and so there's more energy dissipated, so your resistance goes up, okay? And of course, for increased charge carrier concentration, a lot of times we illustrate this as an energy band, okay? And so remember that electrons, this is the conduction band, okay? So a lot of times, some electrons are below this line, some are above, okay? And so when you heat a substance up, some of these electrons gain energy and cross to become conducting. And of course, you have more charge carriers, that means your resistance drops. So what is important to understand is that for an NTC thermistor or for a semiconductor in general, the effect number two is now much larger than effect number one, and therefore overall your resistance will decrease. And so it turns out that semiconductors, structurally speaking, have a lot of electrons which are just below this conduction band. And so when you increase the temperature of a system, you have a large number of these guys who are now crossing to become conducting electrons. And so the significance of effect number two is now very, very large compared to number one. And so overall resistance drops, which is what is illustrated in this IV graph.